नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। तो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी और वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टिश्यू इंजीनियरिंग एंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द टिश्यू इंजीनियरिंग एंड दिस इज बिलोंग विद द सब्जेक्ट मेडिकल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। ओके, सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड व्हाट इज द रीजनरेटिव मेडिसिन एंड वी हैव very well know the component of the regenerative medicine. So tissue engineering is one of the component of the regenerative medicine. As we have discussed that there are various components are there, like the stem cells therapy, the biomaterials, the tissue engineering, so that all collectively makes the regenerative medicine. So we, in the regenerative medicine, that is the process, we require many things. Okay, so one of thing is the tissue engineering. So in this lecture, we will have a detailed information about the tissue engineering. So what is the tissue engineering? As its name suggests, the tissue, that is the part of our organ or the collection of the cells, and engineering. So engineering is a stream that deals with the structural formation, like for the buildings, for the machinery formation and making. So what it is doing in the biology? So what is the tissue engineering? So formation of tissue, okay, so is it that? Yes, so it is the use of the combination of cells, engineering and materials methods, and the suitable biochemical and physiochemical factors to improve or replace the biological tissue. Okay, so we are here making some tissue or some organs outside the body in the lab, and in that process we are involving many things, like first we are using the cells, that are the stem cells. Then we are using the principle of the engineering, and we are using some materials like the growth factors, some hormones, some buffers, and some methods we are using. Okay, like the cell culture methods are there, cell detection, the viability test we can check the functions of the cells and the tissues, and simultaneously we are using the suitable biochemical and physiochemical factors that helps to improve the and replace the biological tissues which we want to replace because they are damaged. Okay, so that is the tissue engineering. So the tissue engineering involves the use of the tissue scaffolds for the formation of the new viable tissue for a medical purpose. So the tissue which are formed using the tissue scaffolds may be used for some clinical purpose, or they can be used as experimental purposes in the laboratory. Okay, so in the routine in cell culture labs, the experiments are performed on the cells which are grown on the culture plates or in the culture flask. So that is a 2D way to know the function of the cells or the effect of some unknown or known drug on the human cells or the different animal cells. So that is not comparable with the in vivo system, or you need to use the human volunteers. Okay, so you do not use the human volunteers for the ethical reasons at any time. So we need some model which is our own, which is humans model, and that can be very similar to the in vivo system or the original organs. So the tissue engineering can provide the an alternative between the in vivo and in vitro system. So it forms a 3D model, 3D tissues can be formed, 3D organ can be formed, which are similar to the original tissues or organs. that can be used for the experimental purposes that are very near to the invivo systems. Okay, so it was once categorized as a subfield of the biomaterials, and having grown in scope and importance, it can be considered as a field in its own. So it's up to you that you can consider this as a subfield of the biomaterials or a different field. Okay, because we use the biomaterials in the tissue engineering. So it have a wide range of applications. In practice, the terms is closely associated with the applications that repair or replace the portions of the whole tissue. Okay, so whole tissue, in that we can make the bone tissue, we can make the cartilage, some blood vessels can be formed, bladder, skin and muscles can be formed outside the body in the lab using the tissue engineering. Okay, but the complex organs cannot be, or maybe very very difficult to make, because making of a tissue or organ is not a different task, but the functioning, proper functioning is a big deal. So after making the organ or tissue, it should perform the proper function. So often the tissues involved in require certain mechanical and the structural properties for proper functioning. Okay, for example, our muscles have some stiffness, they have some elasticity, they have some physical properties. Okay, so that property should reflect in your material which you are making using the tissue engineering. Okay, so that is very difficult to made. So the term has also been applied to efforts to perform the specific biochemical functions using cells within an artificially created support system. Okay, so for example, an artificial pancreas is there, or a bio-artificial liver is there. So the term that we have already studied, the regenerative medicine, is often used to simultaneously with the tissue engineering. So many things that the regenerative medicine and the tissue engineering are same thing, but of course they have the common things, but they are somewhat different. So although those involved in the regenerative medicine place more emphasis on the use of the stem cells or progenitor cells to produce the tissues. Okay, so in the regenerative medicine, it is a different process. It have utilized the tissue engineering principles also. And in the tissue engineering, that is somewhat a sub category of the regenerative medicine, or we can say that the tissue engineering is one of the component of the regenerative medicine. Okay, so to achieve a good results using the tissue engineering, we have to consider various things. Like first of all, because it is a cell based thing, so we have to make a specified cells using a specified cells. So generally we take the cells from the host itself. Means if we want to replace the damaged tissue from a burn patient, so we have to isolate, we have to take the stem cells from that person. And after isolating the stem cells, we will take the help of the cell culture methods, and we will grow the stem cells in the laboratory. After growing that, the stem cells, we will differentiate it in the specified organ. So the organ which is affected, okay, or the organ which is burned. So we will modify that tissue, that stem cells in that particular cell types. And then we can implant after growing or after checking the proper functioning. Okay, so cell culture itself it's a different thing, and it also needs the perfection. because they are very prone or sensitive to the contamination. The human cells are very sensitive towards the contamination. So we have to maintain proper sterilization conditions to when we are growing these cells, stem cells. Okay, so the tissue engineering may increase the healing capacity of the patient. Okay, if the part which is damaged is very large, so naturally it will take longer time to heal. But if we are capable to give the healing as a support by the artificially made tissue engineered tissues or cells, so it will recover very fast. Okay, so that's one of the part of the tissue engineering. And because there are many cases of burns are there, and there are many cases of the accidents are there, in that case actually it happens that because the our body do not accept the other part. Okay, it consider them as a foreign particle. So either we have to use the stem cells, or we have to use the different part of the same patient for the transplantation. For suppose if the damage is on the hand, then we can use the different site of the same patient for the grafting. Okay, we want that the damage will recover very fast, so we will graft the tissues from one place to the damaged place of the patient. So that is the one thing we can perform. And the other thing we can perform that we grow the cells of stem cells of the patient artificially, and we will implant it. So it is not possible in the accidental cases, because at that time we cannot grow the tissues at that time only. Okay, it is not the spontaneous process, it takes some time. So in the patient in which they have some time and they can wait, we can grow the cells outside, and we can grow the tissues, and we can implant the cells or tissues that are more compatible to that patient, because they are their own cells. Okay, so their body will accept them, rather than we graft the tissues from the other donor. Okay, so that will be somewhat risky. So that's about the tissue engineering. So hope you are satisfied with this detailed session. In the next lectures, we will discuss about the various types of the biomaterials which are used in the tissue engineering. So in this lecture, we only take the introductory part of the tissue engineering. What is the tissue engineering and what involves it? So in the next lecture, we will study that what components of the tissue engineering are there, and what is the biomaterial, what are different types of the biomaterial. We will study in the next lecture. So hope you are satisfied with this tutorial session. And if you have any query or doubt, you can write in the comment box. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.